God, there's an awning on the new store. There's still soap on all the windows.
So?
So, they're hiding something.
Oh, I don't think so, Nettie. I think it's just gonna be some kind of antique store, so.
Well, I'm never going over there.
How are you, buddy? Good to see you.
Oh, hi, Nettie.
Hi.
Is Polly around?
Gosh, she is. It's lunchtime.
Hi. Morning, Frank. Father Meehan.
Hi, Alan.
Good afternoon.
Smoked turkey, am right.
Not today. I think I'm gonna try one of your specials today.
So I'll have, what's that?
I'll have that. The delicious salami, provolone, lettuce, tomato, mayo, and two kinds of mustard in a pita pocket.
I wouldn't.
Okay, well, how about smoked turkey on rye?
Good order. Smoked turkey, rye.
And a big piece of Nettie's apple pie.
Thank you, Father.
So how's your day so far?
A little crazy, actually. Did I tell you I got the photos back from the
drugstore? You won't believe your eyes. Needful things. New kind of store. You won't believe your eyes. Says so right there.
Well, then it must be true. So who's the new owner?
Nobody knows. Not from around here is all.
Supposed to be in school. Got a cold. Is anyone here?
I'm here.
The door was unlocked. I didn't bust in.
Of course it's unlocked. I'm open. You've been here before.
No.
Sure you have. Sure. I never forget a face.
Who are you?
My name is Leland Gaunt. And you are?
Brian Rusk. Nice meeting you, sir.
I'm equally pleased to make your acquaintance, Master Brian. Now, what would you fancy?
Fancy?
Yeah, what would you like? Everything that's here is for sale. But not everything that's for sale is here. I have a basement, you see.
Are you from overseas somewhere?
I'm from Akron.
Where's that? England?
That's in Ohio. Oh, what do you know? There's Wilma Jurzik and her husband, Pete. What do you suppose they're up to?
Buying feed for their turkey farm.
Oh, roast turkey, huh?
No, she's a crazy person.
Now, what'll it be, huh? A Walkman? A mountain bike?
I already got one.
Air Jordans?
I don't know. Sure, yeah, I guess.
Well, of course not. Those are just objects, aren't they? Huh? Just things, nothing really important. Well, suppose you had one wish, Brian. What would you say?
A wish?
One wish. Just one. To make you happy. What would make you happy again? Let's see. Where do we start? What could I possibly have around
Mickey Mantle?
A little before your time, wasn't he?
Well, yeah, I meant the baseball card. I mean, me and my dad, we used to collect them.
Tops or Fleers?
Tops. We had a whole collection of 56 baseball cards.
Al Kaline, Whitey Ford, Roy Campanella, guys of that caliber?
We had every Yankee except Mickey Mantle. Uh-huh. I mean, Moose Gowron was over $65.
Wow. Well, Scouring is one thing, but ooh, Mickey Mantle, that's got to run $600-700.
What? You asked me, right?
I believe I might have something that will make you very happy, Brian. Stay right here.
Oh, my God, look at my butt. I look awful.
No, you look fabulous. Paul, you know how, you're always saying that I'm not all that serious about us?
This is your camera, right? I mean, I don't look like this. I'm gonna commit suicide to look like this.
Polly, will you marry me?
Yeah, sure. Whenever you're serious about it, I gotta go check Maddie and make sure she doesn't burn the french fries again and put me in the poorhouse.
Polly, I am serious.
Mickey Mantle.
Oh.
Tops, 1956. Signed to my good friend, Brian.
Wait a minute, Brian, that's my name. That's impossible.
Best wishes, Mickey Mantle. Now close your eyes, Brian. Close your eyes. Now then, how much would you pay for this car, Brian? Mickey Mantle, Tops, 1956, signed to my good friend, Brian.
No, listen, all I got here is...
Shh, shh, shh. So the buyer must never tell the seller how much he has. If you can't tell a lie, then be still. The first rule of fair trade, Master Brian.
So what do you think?
I can't breathe.
Not as great as it looks. I got it off the TV.
It's a liar. Put it on.
Does that mean yes?
$0.95. Ah, well, now we are getting somewhere. Not quite enough, okay, but an intriguing offer nonetheless. Let's call it half the price, shall we? Yes. Half the price is 95 cents. The price you pay in cash. The rest, the other half, is a deed. You understand?
Deed?
A trick. Well, more like a tiny prank. No big deal. And no one's ever going to suspect you. I promise. Do you remember that lady we peeked at buying feed across the street?
Yeah, Wilma Jersey. A turkey farmer.
Do you know where she lives?
Out of the car. I said get out of the car. Now. Ow! Oh! Is this your name on this goddamn ticket, Ridgewick? Or maybe this is some kind of forgery.
You were parked in the crypt space.
The what?
Wait a minute, you can't come in here.
What?
It's a handicap space, and you've been told about it before, too, Buster, and you
know... What did you call me? Did you call me Buster?
Touch me again, I'll throw you in the goddamn cell. I mean it.
It's Danforth. Danforth Keaton III, who was head selectman of this piss-pot little town, can get your ass fired off the police force and make that 1 second flat. Am I getting through to you, Norris?
I'm the one who told him to write the ticket.
Huh? Well, in that case, my mistake, huh?
Jesus, Dan. What else got into you today?
Nothing got into me. I'm just sick and tired of self-important little pricks. Pusillanimous assholes.
That's enough.
Because I try to do a lot for this town. I accomplish a lot for this town. In fact, I am this town. And I am sick and tired of this goddamn persecution.
I'm not persecuting you, Dan.
He called me Buster. You know how I feel about that.
Then he'll apologize. Won't you, Norris?
I don't know that I will.
You will. Now.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I called you Buster.
Mama's boy, you candy ass.
Oh, shut up, you bloated cigar-sucking used car salesman.
Boots! Shithead! I sell quality pre-owned yachts, you miserable fucking scum.
Shut up!
You know, guys, I moved here and I thought, great, I'm out of the big city and I'm finally in a place where everybody isn't gonna be crawling up everybody's asshole every day. A place where maybe my biggest nightmare was gonna be getting some goddamn cat out of a tree. But forget that! Everybody is insane everywhere! So you guys just fight it out between you. One of you kill each other and who's ever left, I'll throw in jail.
You can do it. I know you can. He's not gonna bite. But what will I say? You introduce yourself. Hi, I'm Nettie. Then what? Nettie, just go. You'll be fine. Hi, I'm Nettie.
Thank you, Miss Butterfield. Well, it's only 19th century, I'm sorry. Enjoy your purchases.
What's this? Some old wood chisel?
It belonged to a cabinet maker at Chateau de Versailles in the days of Louis XVI.
Look at this, Pete. Looks pretty old.
Yeah?
Oh, my God, I didn't think we had room for another soul in here.
Hi. My name's Nettie.
That stupid dog barks at me one more time. I won't bother complaining to Sheriff Pangborn again. I'll come over your place, skin him alive.
No, not in here, dear God, please. What nonsense is it?
Throw her Baptist ass in the street.
I will not, dear ladies. Let's all be friends. Can't we all be friends?
Not in this life.
Oh, please, not. I'm sorry. Ladies, excuse me. Mrs. Pick it up. Go ahead. Go on. Don't be afraid, Miss Cobb.
I had one just like it years ago.
Oh.
But it got broke. My husband.
Oh, your husband? Then it's Mrs. Cobb.
Although my charge has been passed on for some time now. Oh, he died untimely.
I'm so sorry to hear that.
No need to be sorry. It's been 7 years since he was...
Murder is awful.
I didn't mean to.
Of course not. It wasn't you who took that meat fork from the drawer and stuck it in Mr. Cobb's throat. Are you leaving, Mrs. Roberts?
Well, I'll have to think about it. It is a lot of money.
Well, you think about it, so will I. Oh, you bake this?
Of course. Homemade every day from apples, picked down to Mayflowers. Polly Chalmers, my boss, sent it over.
Go ahead. Take him.
I'm scared I'll drop it again.
You won't drop it. Come, Mrs. Cobb. Please, sit down. Sometimes I think I can hear the tiniest laugh. Like you, Letitia.
Oh.
I won't yell at you like George did. For a bite. Mr. Keaton eats there most every day, does he?
Oh, yeah. Danforth Keaton. And everybody calls him Buster behind his back.
Oh, why is that? Pray tell.
I don't know.
Maybe someone should play a trick on Buster. Teach him to be nice.
My husband played a lot of tricks on me.
Maybe it would be fun to play one on someone else. Nobody would ever know it was you, I promise. Come to Needful Things.
Alan Pangborn, sheriff around these parts.
Leland Gaunt, owner. So what can I sell you, Sheriff?
Me? Oh, nothing. I got everything I need, thanks.
Fair enough. How about a piece of pie? Your fiancée, Miss Chalmers, sent it over.
My fiancée?
Such a pretty lady. You're a lucky man, Sheriff. Good luck. Woohoo! Oh, goodness. I wish I had some cheddar cheese. Beggars can't be choosers, can they? Say, we haven't met somewhere before, have we?
Are you and me?
In a big city. You look familiar, Al. You look out of place here, actually.
Well, you don't mind my saying so. So do you, Leland. So where are you from?
Pittsburgh. I'm from Pittsburgh.
So why did you leave?
Well, I was a cop there, and I got tired of all this shit going down. And one day, I just lost it. I hit this guy. Way too hard.
Well, I reckon he needed some killing.
But it was, still wrong.
Of course it was.
So I left. Now I'm here.
So am I.
Thanks for coming.
Afternoon, Father.
Hi, Sheriff.
I got this in the mail this morning.
Listen up, you mackerel snapper.
Excuse me.
We have tried to reason with you, but it's been no use. We have put up with your popish idolatry and even with your licentious worship of the Babylon whore, but now you've gone too far. Babylon whore, I mean, saints preserve us. Heed our warning. Give up your plan to turn this town into a den of thieves and gamblers, or you will smell the brimstone. The wicked shall be turned into hell. Psalms 9:17. The concerned Baptist men of Castle Rock. Is that Egypt, Reverend Willie Rose?
Maybe you shouldn't have called it casino night.
Oh, for God's sake, Alan, it's only a little charity gambling. I don't know why it upsets the Baptists so.
Well, I'll go talk to
Reverend. When I was younger, people got along better.
I'll go talk to him. I'll get to the bottom of it.
Oh, you do that, Alan. And when you do, you tell Rose that if he tries to bump us, he'll find out just how hard we mackerel snappers can bump back.
Pete, you get me a gobbler from the pen. I feel like turkey tonight.
You feel like turkey every night, Wilma.
What happened?
Mud! Mud? Mud and shit! Goddamn turkey shit!
I mean, why'd someone go and do that?
Because I told her I'll kill it.
Told who?
Dad? Yes, just a sec. It's for you. Okay, it's the square key. Mm-hmm. All the doors. Don't forget the lights. You can do it. You'll be fine. I'll see you in the morning.
Night.
Hi, this is Nettie.
I know what you've done, you crazy bitch!
Done what?
Fucking with me was the worst mistake you ever made. I'm gonna get you for this, you understand? You and your mutt!
You don't dare! You stop bothering me and my Raider! He's a good doggy.
You won't see me coming.
He sounds like he's having a fucking epileptic fit.
Yep.
Don't kick the rock, all of you. You hear me? How are you doing at the tracks, Dan?
horses finally running your way?
Every time, Henry. Every goddamn time.
I'm gonna kick that jukebox wide open. You don't fix it, Henry.
All right, that's it. You're out of here.
Hey, give me that back.
Any of you fellas heading up to Castle Hill? You needs a lift.
Pink slip is what you need. Or a city employee making an ass of himself in a public tavern.
Yep.
Nice to have friends.
You know, Henry, you know what they do? They do it at night. They come in and they take out the mirrors and they put in a piece of one-way glass and they stick a camera on the other side of it. And they watch you. And they laugh at you. And they take down every single word you say. Yeah.
You're drenched to your soul.
They threw me out. I'm sorry.
Here, let me help you peel this thing off before you catch your death.
You got a nice jacket in the window.
A classic early 50s beauty. Warm as toast, dry as a bone.
It's just like the one I used to have in high school before I was a bum. When I was a kid.
I bet there are quite a few people in this shit pit of a town who wouldn't believe you ever were a kid, huh?
I know. It's not fair. I try so hard.
Not hard enough. So they crushed you, huh? And they buried that wonderful boy deep inside you.
Which boy?
This one. We'll find him again, you. We'll resurrect him together, huh? Because all of a sudden, it's 1955 all over again.
Rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Couldn't hit the ridge, whip all the fire. I left in love, I thought it was funny, but you came along.
It was the best hour of the best day of my life. I love that jacket.
This jacket? This one? This jacket, you? You could recover. Retrace your steps. Take charge of your life again, huh?
God, this is still so beautiful.
Say, Hugh, do you happen to know a nice little Baptist lady called Nettie Corn?
Sure. Crazy old rips killed her husband. How much do you want for it?
Mr. Gaunt?
I am he.
Reverend Rose, sir, of the First Baptist Church of Castle Rock. May I take this opportunity to welcome you to Castle Rock on the good Lord's behalf?
Why not?
Excellent, excellent. It's my unusual urgency when I ask, what
faith, sir, are you? What faith?
Religion. You're not Catholic, are you?
You might say that I am, well, non-denominational.
Aha, I knew it. Then you will have little objection to my placing this in your front window.
No, I couldn't possibly do that.
I, like you, am here to serve everyone. However, by way of compensation, perhaps I may offer you something which might interest you.
Say, how about an objet d'art?
What is your preference, Reverend? Asian, Roman? That is second century. Wasn't it St. Augustine who said, make me chaste, O Lord, but not yet.
Father? Reverend?
Are my favorite things.
Yes, I'm so thrilled. Thank you, Mr. Gaunt.
Treasure Island. First edition, actually. Signed by Robert Louis Stevenson himself.
It's magnificent.
Thank you, Gander. If it's too hot in here, Mr. Jewett, just say the word. I'm afraid I have a tendency to turn up the heat. What's wrong?
How long have you been there?
Oh, I was just hoping for a cup of coffee. I didn't realize you were closing.
Coffee, sure, no problem. You're Mr. Gaunt.
And you're Polly Chalmers.
I'm sorry, I don't shake hands. I have
arthritis. Forgive me, I forgot. You've been having a devil of a time with it lately, haven't you?
Yes. How did you know?
Nettie told me. Oh, here. Just a tiny thank you note for that remarkable pie. Oh, my Lord. I don't think I ever had a tastier cup of coffee. By any chance, I have something in the way of a donut. Something I might dunk, Miss Chalmers.
Oh, please, we're going to be neighbors. Why don't you call me Polly?
Like that.
Put the gun down, Dan.
Yeah.
Jeez. Another couple of seconds, would have been out of here. You would have missed me. What can I do for you?
I had a call from the state auditors.
Yeah?
We have an appropriations committee meeting next week to discuss budgetary matters.
Hey, guess what? It's on my calendar.
They want to be there. They want me to bring them printouts. Shit from City Hall.
Yeah, well, you know those bastards, they're on some kind of fishing expedition or something.
What the hell's going on?
I've been having some bad luck at the track lately. So I borrowed some money from the town petty cash fund just to cover the shortfall.
Jesus, Dan.
I'm gonna pay it back. I was gonna pay it back before next week, honest to God.
How much are we talking about here?
$20,000.
$20,000? Jesus Christ.
I'm getting a loan on my dealership to pay it back from Boston.
When?
Any day now. 2 days, 4 days, next week.
4 days. 4 days.
How's my boy? You have something that's mine, Brian, that you haven't finished paying for.
But you said I could have it
if... The dealing isn't done, you see. Until Mr. Gaunt says the dealing is done. Sold this to me. His father made a fortune from it. Every morning, he'd take the day's racing form and run its races before they ever happened, one by one, right on this board. And give each tin horse a real name from the paper, do it just by touching and whispering. Brand new name.
Citation.
Seabiscuit, Whirlaway,
Seattle Slough,
Man of War, whoever were running that day. Line her up. Let her go. Run the whole damn slate that way.
Northern Dancer.
8, 10, a dozen races. Then go right to the track and bet on those fillies that won on this astonishing toy from Japan Incorporated. And rake in the cash, Dan. Rake in the goddamn cash.
Break in the cash. How much?
Good day to you.
Good morning, Father.
Morning, Father. Mm-hmm.
What do you want?
Coffee and the usual.
Hey, Corn Cob. What's the button on your boob? You're crazy. You leave me alone.
Take it easy, Nettie. Nettie, put the knife down. Okay, Wilma, what'll it be?
Raider on Rye, a little glass of puppy pus, and two nice doggy eyes.
Why don't you just order up or get out?
Wilma.
Oh, shit.
It's okay. It's okay. I'll go talk to her.
Junction salute. She's a hellraiser. Tammy's wonder, easy sweep. Dad's my friend. Yes, okay, little puppy. You ready now? Let's run a good race. Ready, set, go! Rentier, Countess Ridge, Rancadu, By George, and Confucius Sings, little Chinese puppy. Hey, okay, fellas, let's go. Come on. Make money for daddy!
The white one, it's the red one, it's the pink one,
it's
the blue one, it's the green one. Oh, God, they're beautiful. Look at those beautiful
fucking horses.
Come on, run, run, run,
come on. Yeah, I'm gonna love my martini.
Yeah,
aren't you going to work?
I am at work.
Well, then, would you like me to go down to the bakery, Danforth, and maybe get us some nice honey-dipped donuts?
Yeah. Honey-dipped donuts, yeah. Toilet paper, a nose job. Just leave me alone! You ready now? Let's run a good race. Ready, set, go! They're off. They're coming around the corner. Whoa, it's a runaway victory. Yes, come on, come on!
On the no-hitter, and we're in the bottom of the ninth inning. A count of two and two on the batter. Two men on base, but Brian has walked them both, and right now he's checking the runners leading off first and second. He's gotten the sign from the catcher. The runners lead away, and here's the pitch. Strike three. How about that? Will he make that no-hitter, or will he not? Brian Rusk. Is he really sharp today? Sensational control of his 90-mile-an-hour fastball. Still a chance of a no-hitter, and He's ready to work. Ruska has got a great curveball that's dipping and darting in his fastball. They can't touch it. Ryan Rusk is delivering a performance that can take the Yankees to another World Series. How about that? Ryan Rusk is ready, and he delivers. And the pitch.
Three, we're having fun now.
Hey, Rita. Hey, little pal. Good fella, yeah, ain't ya? And ain't you got a face just cute as a baby bug? Yes, you do, yes. And you know what I got, huh? I got a beautiful jacket. Yes, I do. And you know what else? I'm gonna keep it.
They're running the band in yellow and white and pink.
Thank you.
Tom.
My microwave, you crazy fuck!
Homer!
There's nothing quite so invigorating as a crisp fall day in New England. Don't you agree?
Mr. Gaunt.
Oh, Leland.
Leland. I'm sorry, I can't even think.
Forgive me, Polly. I know you are in pain. So I shall dispense with the small talk. I'll give you the item I called you about. And send you home.
Give it to me?
More or less. But let us leave that until later, shall we? Oh, when it rains, it pours.
They're after me.
Go upstairs, Mr. Keaton, to my apartment. Make yourself a nice cup of tea. I'll be with you in a minute.
I don't have a minute.
Go upstairs.
They weren't actually feeling much better. And then just a few minutes before you called, they started swelling up.
Polly, I know a great deal about the past. And this is very, very old. Egyptian. Not as old as the pyramids, no, but still.
Do you have a glass of water? I need to take my pills.
Not any longer. You see, this is called an Azka. It is a tool of Benkelitis, white magic. And they say it wards off pain.
Please, my pills. Really, I'm not superstitious.
It doesn't matter, Polly. This is...
Oh!
I'm sorry. Must be the storm.
Oh. What storm?
Oh, I assure you. There is one coming. Now. Put it inside your sweater. Wear it right next to your skin, Polly.
My hands, I can't even unbutton my sweater.
Never take it off, Polly. Not ever.
A heinous double murder or bizarre act of revenge gone awry. Sheriff Alan Pangborn is running a problem.
House. They sent Norris Ridgwick.
Yes. Yeah, how did you know?
They're so predictable.
I need your advice. I think I should kill Norris Ridgwick.
Oh, no. That would make things far too easy for them, Dan. They'd come get you, hunt you down like an animal. Cop killer. Oh, they'd have a party. They'd get all liquored up in Sheriff Pangborn's office. They'd go out to Homeland Cemetery and urinate on your grave.
I hate this place. I hate these people.
But they're all part of it, Dan. You know that. All your Weasley fellow selectmen, all your so-called friends. But Sheriff Pangborn, he's the big shot ringleader. He came in from the outside, Dan.
to take over your town. And oh boy, would he love it if you blew away one of his little drones.
So what should I do?
Nothing. Well, I'll keep this gun for a while. Save you from yourself.
You just go for the races tonight, Dan. Win yourself a bundle. So confusion and uncertainty amidst the infamous.
Confusion and uncertainty.
That's my point. See, in the meantime, I'm laying my own plans. And when the great moment comes, for everything you do, Danforth, this one's for you.
Almighty and eternal God, hear our prayers for your daughter Wilma, whom you have taken from this life to yourself. Grant her light, happiness, and peace. Let her pass in safety through the gates of death. Dwell with all your saints in the blessed light that you
the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Faith. He maketh me to lie
guard
down in green
from
pastures.
All harm.
He leadeth
Upon
me beside
great day
the still
of resurrection
waters.
And reward.
He restoreth my soul.
Your saints.
He leadeth me
Pardon
in the paths
sins.
Of righteousness for his
Let
name's
dwell
sake.
In thy eternal
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
Listen, I need to talk to the sheriff.
No,
I gotta tell
son, sheriff's got his hands full.
Brian, you didn't happen to see this happen, did you?
No.
Well, you have any idea who threw these apples?
No.
Well, then maybe you better go on home.
How far away were you? Watch
it. Easy. Whoa, easy, Brian.
Why'd they do it? I mean, if you had to guess.
You're asking the wrong guy. I don't understand anyone anymore.
You want the knife or the cleaver?
Somebody didn't hear or see something.
Morning, Norris.
Nice of you to drop by, Debbie Ridgeworth.
Well, Brian Nettie's again this morning. Found this in the alley behind her house. Yeah, I bet Wilma could have done the job on the dog with that knife, all right.
Well, congratulations, Deputy. Nice work. Run it for Prince. I bet you 10-1 to not Wilma's.
Well, why not? I mean, it figures if Nettie threw the apples, Wilma must have killed the dog.
Because Nettie didn't throw those apples. Would you go over to someone's house to kill them and then spend half an hour breaking all their windows first?
But if Nettie didn't throw those apples, then who did?
Maybe the same person killed the damn dog.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna pay Brian Rusk a visit. And I want you guys to canvass the neighborhood. Somebody must have seen something.
Sheila, I'm not shitting you. The most disgusting murder I've seen in my 6 years. I mean, even worse than that lady with the meat grinder.
I don't want to hear. Hello, Sheriff's Department.
Sheila.
I'm sorry, Father. He's not here right now. Can I take him?
Is this for me?
I'll tell him. Thank you.
Is this
I
for
have
me?
No idea what that is, Norris.
It looks like a present,
Hello,
Norris.
Sheriff's
Why don't you go
Department?
And open it?
Yes, it is, but...
Shit! Ow! God damn it!
Get it off! Get it
Norris,
off! Get it off!
Still.
Get it off! Get
still,
it off!
Norris!
Get it...
Nope,
shit!
Come with it.
Shit!
Let me see that.
Crypt space is all yours now.
Buster, that
son of a bitch! Damn!
Should have read the card first.
Brian, you around?
Brian, you were trying to tell me something last night back there out at the Jurassic farm, weren't you? What was it?
Nothing anymore.
Well, what's bothering you, son?
Hmm?
I mean, you don't have to be afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Between you and me, bullshit.
Look, he's a monster.
A what? Who?
I dreamt about him last night. Only he's real.
Sometimes if you talk about it, the scary stuff goes away.
No. No, not monsters.
Even monsters, Bri. Whoa.
Don't come any closer. You'll get the stuff on you.
Okay, Brian, take it easy. Take it easy now. You tell me what you're really scared of, and I know that we can make it go away.
No. It's too late. I gotta go. I gotta go to hell.
What do you mean?
Don't go in that store. Don't go near it.
Okay, I promise. I promise you, I'll never go in there. What store are you talking about? Needful Things?
It's a poison place. And he's a poison man.
Who's a poison man?
Mr. Gaunt. Only he's not a man.
Wow, Mickey Mantle. 1956. It's signed to you and everything. It's yours, huh? Boy, you sure don't want to lose something like this.
Mickey Mantle sucks!
Everybody that's got it coming is gonna get it now.
Get out of here!
What's wrong?
Brian Rusk tried to kill himself.
Oh, God.
He's alive, but I was there, and I could have stopped him. 11-year-old kid tries to eat a bullet.
Why?
I don't know. Polly, when did Nettie ever say anything to you about Gaunt? Anything strange?
What do you mean?
You got any aspirin? My head's ripped apart.
Henry Beaufort. That bastard runs the Melatonga. Cut my tires. Threw me out in the rain in my beautiful jacket.
Maybe then you should just go take care of Henry. Once and for all, Hugh.
Once and for all?
Yeah. But don't be afraid of it, Hugh. Guns don't kill people. People kill people. You know, Hugh, I've been in this business a long time. When I started out, I was just a poor wandering peddler on the blind face of a distant land. Moving. Always gone. Asia, Anatolia, Palestine, Macedonia. Year after year after year. And in the end, I always offered them weapons. And they always bought. But of course, I was gone before they finally realized what I had purchased.
Oh, Jesus.
The young carpenter from Nazareth? I knew him well. Promising young man. He died badly.
What is this? Gaunt gave this to you.
Well, he didn't give it to me.
And then it made the pain go away, didn't it? Take it off. It's a disease. It looks like a cure.
Are you crazy?
Take it off. I want to see what's inside this goddamn thing.
No! You. Don't you want me to feel better?
Take it easy, will you?
No, you take it easy. They're my hands. You're not the one who can't sleep at night. You're not the one with the goddamn oversized buttons on the telephone.
Yeah, an oversized Percodan prescription.
Hello? Yes, he is. He's right here. Whoever he is.
Yeah. Okay. That's what I thought. Thanks, Norris. Mr. Leland Gaunt never ran a business in Akron, Ohio.
You checked on him?
He's a con man, Polly, or something worse. There have been two murders and an attempted suicide in this quiet little town in the last 48 hours, and Mr. Leland Gaunt is at the bottom of it.
Wilma Jurczyk killed Nettie. Brian shot himself. You were there. Where are you going? It's boring.
Good. He'll be home.
Sure. Put it back on, Polly. The pain will go away. I promise.
What's inside? I have to know.
I'm terribly sorry. I can't tell you that. That would spoil the fun, wouldn't it? $20. Does that seem a fair price to ease the pain?
My purse.
$20. And a small favor.
What sort of favor? No, he's not.
And a thief?
No.
Alan and old Buster Keaton have been embezzling from the town treasury, dear lady. And the tax man is closing in. Check his boat if you don't believe me. All he's going to do is cause you pain. Do as I say, and you'll never feel pain again. You see, when everything else is gone, isn't a young woman at least entitled to her pride? The coin without which your purse is entirely empty, huh?
Oh, oh, please. Oh, please. Please.
Well, I've always so enjoyed those ladies who take great pride in themselves. You must realize what a deep pleasure it is doing business with you.
Come on.
twice, Alan.
He was there. Every time he was there.
What? Who?
Look at this. England, Ohio, Honolulu, Chicago, Sacramento, Cuba, Castle Rock.
Who was where?
Gaunt. Mr. Leland Gaunt. Every goddamn time.
Come on, Alan. 1894?
Sheriff's Department.
It's Polly, Alan.
Where the hell are you? I just tried calling your place.
I'm on your boat. How could you?
How could I what? Listen, I want to find him. Call up Andy and John, APB, the works. Also state. I also want APB on Dan Keaton, right. Hugh Priest. Yeah, I'm sorry. What?
I found the money, Alan.
Oh, what money?
The money that you and Dan Keaton have been embezzling from the town treasury.
Wait. What are you talking about?
I can put two and two together, Alan. I'm not stupid. I heard you covering up for him on the phone with that tax guy. I saw the two of you at his dealership the other night. I'm standing here looking at thousands of dollars on your desk.
Who the hell's been planting this idea in your head? You've been talking to Gaunt. Polly, listen to me. I don't know what you found, but first of all, if I stole some money, you think I'd leave it laying around on my desk? The guy is evil. Don't go near him. He's Brian's monster. Somehow, they're newspapers, Polly. He's not a human being.
Andy, this is Norris. Listen, get over to
the
office right
now. You're calling him
Leland?
I am not.
Don't ask why, just do it.
Polly, listen to me. Stay where you are, okay? Look, stay there, will you? I'm coming right over, okay? I'm coming home.
Alan, wait a minute. What do you mean he's a monster? I met the guy. Listen, he looks like my uncle. My card! You son of a bitch! Whoa! I get you! I get all of you!
Get this, you fat fuck!
Oh, shit! Ah! God, you! Look! Look, you think I would know? Huh? With your name on every goddamn ticket! Making fun of me! God damn you, son of a bitch! You! The little prick works for you! Son of a bitch! Give that little kid your gun. What the hell are you thinking about, Keaton?
Hey, Norris, you still alive? Can you handle this or not? Get your breath. Okay, you all right? You okay?
Yeah.
Look at me.
Yeah. Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah, yeah.
Get your shit together. Lock this son of a bitch up. I gotta go see Paul. Oh.
Pathetic piece of shit.
I am not a piece of shit!
Shut up! This is for my surprise package.
No, no! Oh, no, no!
Buster. Gotcha.
Polly, you here? Pa?
Thank you.
thought you died on the John.
Danforth, what's wrong? Oh,
nothing's wrong. Things are better than they've been in years. I just need a little help, that's all.
Danforth, you're handcuffed to the door.
Well, aren't you the fucking genius? Give me that hacksaw, will you?
What did you do?
Forget the hacksaw. Give me that hammer and the big screwdriver. Now, you moron! Where do you think you're going, huh?
Danforth, I can't reach.
Oh, well, that's a drill. Did I ask for a drill? Why won't you help me?
Danforth, I can't see.
I guess you want me to let you go so you can run back in the house and call them, huh? Oh, that's one. Now, how about trying for two?
Danforth, you broke the law, didn't you?
Oh, did I break their law? Huh? How about you, Myrtle? Did you break the law? Did you sleep with him just to humiliate me?
Oh. Did I what?
Norris Ridgewick. Did you fuck him? After the two of you put up all those goddamn parking tickets all over my house?
No! And it's our house, Buster.
Master's voice. How is it going?
I killed my wife. Is that wrong? I didn't mean to.
Hey, these things happen. Did she deserve it?
I don't know. I really loved her.
Well, there are those times when you simply must hurt the ones you loved, eh? I just can't picture Danforth Keaton doing something to someone who didn't deserve it. You aren't that kind of guy, are you?
I don't know anymore.
Get a hold of yourself, Danforth. It's no good, all this self-pity. Why don't you hop in your car, come see me, huh? I got something for you. I think you'll get a bang out of it.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Amen.
Why are you talking to there, Danny boy?
God. Just God.
My time.
I just want to tell you that I'm really scared.
You tell me nothing. I tell you everything.
Yeah.
They have it coming, Dan.
Yeah.
You know they do.
Yeah, I know. So why don't you just crush them all now? Why don't you just split the earth wide open?
Because I don't work miracles.
I'm not the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I'm just one lonely guy.
Please, please, please. I just want to die, please. I just want to die.
I won't disappoint you. I promise. Come see me when you're done. Now,
yeah,
dig.
Yeah, but I'm digging.
You are disgusting. Yeah,
yeah.
I like that in a person.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, yes, thank you.
Sorry about Buster, I fucked up. Forgive that son of a bitch.
Who's there?
Well, it's late.
I need to talk to you, Father.
What's the matter? Do you believe in the devil, Father? I guess I have to. You can't have one without the other. But do you believe in God, Alan?
What's he look like?
Look like?
Yeah, the devil. What the hell does he look like?
Well, he looks like you and me, I imagine.
So he could get his claws in us without our ever knowing it. Make us do things that we normally would never do. Terrible things.
No, I don't think so, Alan. People have a choice.
This is a good town.
Right.
It was a good town. A lot of decent, ordinary people. Only now the devil is here.
Oh, the devil's always here, Alan. And he's always in our hearts. But with the good Lord's help, we can help cast him out.
No fucking hearts in our town, right outside in our streets. The devil is in Castle Rock. His name's Leland Gaunt. I need your help to get rid of him.
No. Leland Gaunt is a decent man.
My God. You got to your devil.
If there's a devil in this town, it's that damned Reverend Willie Rose!
Father? You still think he's a decent man? The devil just blew up your damn church!
That's not the devil! It's those goddamn Baptists! Rose!
Rose! Rose! Damn you to hell!
Stevenson, first edition! Get out of our way!
Hey. You okay? Huh? You all right?
You're in the truck. Go home. Watch some television or something.
All hell's broke loose. And Baptists are running around crazy because their church is on fire. But somebody went and killed Myrtle Keaton with a hammer. What the hell happened here? Jesus. You son of a bitch!
Oh, no!
Got a riot on our hands.
My pleasure.
Bruce! In the name of Christ, man, beg for his mercy, because you'll get none from me.
He's struck down by his almighty swift sword.
Stop it!
Ian, you godless heathen!
Rot in hell, Willie Rose!
Father, stop it! You'll kill it!
Fuck you!
God damn it, stop it! I'll blow your fucking head off!
Now, there's an idea.
Put the axe down now.
Go to hell!
Shoot him!
Put it down!
Fuck you!
Kill him! Kill him! Kill him! Kill them all! Get God sort them out!
No! No more killing! Not in Castle Rock! Not me! Not you! Not anybody! This shit stops now! Listen to me! All of you! This man here, Leland Gaunt!
We're waiting.
He came here to destroy us, to make us destroy ourselves. Can't you see what's happening here? This is what he needs. This is what he wants. He's got us all lined up like a bunch of human fuse boxes. He hot wires Wilma Jerzyk to Nettie Cobb, except he does it with wires from two other fuse boxes, Brian Ruskin, whoever it was that skinned a poor dog, because it sure as hell wasn't Wilma, was it, Pete?
No, sir.
And then he cross-wires all the rest of us the same way. What'd he make you do, Eddie? Myra Frank? How about you, Karen? What price did you have to pay for your needful thing? Father Mean, Reverend Rose, look at yourselves. Cora, your little boy is in a hospital because he knew what this man is. And he tried to tell me, but I got sucked in just like everybody else. Don't you see what he's done? We're all decent people. We are. And he's preyed on our weaknesses, on our hatred and our greed and our prejudice and our fear. Don't you understand? He runs on hate. And he's used it to turn us all against each other. Wilma Jerzyk, Nettie Cobb, Dan Keaton, Norris Ridgwick,
Alan Pangborn and Polly Chalmers.
He made me steal Mr. Jewett's Treasure Island.
Frank, what did he make you do?
He made me rip up Ruth Roberts' flower bed.
He made me send that letter to Father Meehan.
I gave the rat trap to Norris Ridgwick.
They had me slash Hugh Priest's tires.
I was the one that planted the money on your boat, Alan. I'm sorry.
Oh, this is pathetic. You're all so pathetic. Look at you. Puppets, all of you. And he is pulling the strings. Listen, I dealt as I always do. I show people what I have to sell, and then I let them make up their own mind. Is that so wrong? I ask you.
You're done here, Gaunt. Yeah. You're busted. You're finished in this town.
Alan!
Oops.
Anybody's finished in this town, it's you, Pangborn.
Finally, a man with some sense.
You guys sound like a fucking AA meeting. Hi, my name is Dan, and I'm here to blow up your fucking town.
You're all gonna pay big. Pay huge.
Keep calm, folks. Don't give them a reason.
I got a reason, you shithead. I got a lifetime full of reason.
Talk, talk, talk. For Christ's sake. Just blow him away, Dan.
Don't do it, Dan. Don't let this third-rate bastard turn you into something worse than he is.
Shut up, Pangborn!
It's too late.
Don't move. Don't you move!
Time's running out, Buster.
I killed my Myrtle already. Now I just gotta die.
No, you don't, Dan. You didn't kill your Myrtle. He did. You don't have to do this.
Yes, you do.
Yes, I do.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, I do.
Well, then take me with you. Just me. I'm the ringleader. Let these other people go.
No.
No.
Oh, for Christ's sake, put this town out of its misery, Buster. They're whipping you, Buster. They're making you walk their walk and talk their talk. Just do it, Buster.
You're just like the rest of them. It's you.
It was you all along, you cocksucker.
Oh, sticks and stones will break my bones, but names will never hurt me.
Yeah, you killed my Myrtle.
I killed her. Oh, hey, don't blame me. Blame it on the Bossa Nova. But how about you take some responsibility yourself for once in your life, Buster?
I just got one thing to say to you.
Don't call me Buster.
Okay, buddy.
Shouldn't have called him Buster.
Oh, you know, there are days when I really hate this job. This is not my best work, not by a long shot. Oh, sure, a few murders and a couple of rather lovely explosions. I would hardly call it a rousing success, but what the hell? I'll be back. In the meantime, you and Polly, you are two terrific kids. You'll marry her, trust me. She's a lovely girl, Al. You'll have a wonderful family. Oh, by the way, give my regards to your grandson. Bob will be his name. International trade, his game. I'll see him in Jakarta, 2053. August 14th, 10 a.m. A nice sunny day. We'll make headlines. Catch.
Ow! Ooh. Ha!